Thank you, Dave, for David, for the introduction and the invitation. I'm also delighted to be here at this amazing celebration of Suzanne and John's scientific careers. As a vast number of Suzanne's and John's previous PhD students, I always was extremely fortunate and privileged to be mentored by Suzanne and John. So Suzanne was my primary PhD supervisor, and I actually met Suzanne for the first time in 1995, just after I finished my honors and interviewed for a research position in her laboratory. And a week after my interview, Suzanne called me and said, as Sharon mentioned in a true Suzanne style, Katherine, I've got an early Christmas present for you. You got a job. So I started with Suzanne and needless to say, loved every second of it. We did lots of amazing research together. Some of exciting work was on GM-CSF and HIV, for which I got the Otto Wessler Travel Award. And you can see here a couple of slides with John at the award ceremony. And as a result, I went to my first international conference, to the Keystone meeting, as following Suzanne's recommendation, as these were the best meetings to go to for a PhD student. And surely they were, and I still keep going to Keystone meetings, and I make sure that my students go to the Keystone meetings too. But I surely discovered that the Keystone meetings were not only about the cutting edge science. As a week before I left for the meeting, Suzanne came to my desk with a big bag of her skiing gear and advised, Katherine, you need to learn how to ski while in Keystone. So my students now get skiing lessons at the Keystone meetings. But coming back from this conference, buzzing on science, I decided to do a PhD under Suzanne's supervision. And obviously Suzanne was, and still is, the most wonderful mentor. She not only taught me how to do the experiments, but also how to think outside the square, ask large questions, answer them creatively, in a creative way, and package them in publications. She provided me with many opportunities and guidance throughout the year, throughout the years. Suzanne also taught me that it's really important to apply for awards as well as present at the scientific conferences. And my most memorable conference so far has been the 2002 macrophage meeting in Rome. For those who don't know, Suzanne was really passionate about those meetings. She was one of the organizers together with Carlo Perno and Tony Cunningham and organized them for years. And apart from amazing science, what I also learned from Suzanne was that it's good to overdress rather than underdress for the conference meetings. And there always should be time for shopping. And these photos were taken in pre-digital area, but I don't know if you can see Suzanne here shopping at the stall in the streets of Rome on our way to Vatican, for which Suzanne secured us VIP passes, which was quite a unique experience. So apart from Suzanne, John never actually got any official acknowledgement for mentoring me during my PhD, but John always was interested in my PhD results, discussed the data, and critically reviewed the manuscript. And although John's red pen all over my papers was really, really scary, they were really helpful, and I've learned lots from you, John, on the secrets of scientific writing. And most importantly, when I started looking for my postdoctoral position, John said to me that he thinks I'm good enough to apply and work with Peter Doherty, and actually contacted John, Peter on my behalf, and from there I got my dream postdoctoral job. So I often wonder what kind of researcher I would be if I wasn't mentored by Suzanne and John, and for sure I know I wouldn't be where I am today, doing the research I love. So on behalf of all the PhD students, I'd like to thank you both immensely for all your guidance, all the opportunities, being such wonderful mentors, and personally for believing in me and giving me wings. Thank you.